Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. And today, yes, we're talking about the Anastasia Beverly Hills Dream Glow Kit. We're gonna find out if it's really that dreamy and if it's really that glowy. Time. Packaging's really nice. I think you could probably get the gist of it. It sort of has this snake skin kind of texture going on top of it. I'm just gonna open this up. Comes in a typical cardboard packaging. Highlighters look like. The pen size is just the same as all other Anastasia highlighter kits. Swatch them. This is Wish. Okay, that is Wish. It's sort of kind of like peachy with a pink undertone. Next, I'm gonna go and swatch Unicorn. That's Unicorn. It's sort of like pink with a purple shift to it. The formula on these are like quite buttery. That's Unicorn. Next I'm gonna swatch Magic. That's Magic. Now Magic is it sort of looks silvery in the pan. It's sort of pink silvery. That's Magic. I actually like Magic, it's quite unique. I'm gonna swatch Ethereal, that's the lavender one. Oh, Ethereal is also sort of with pink glitter in it. That's Ethereal. Next, I'm gonna swatch Sunshine. Okay, Sunshine's quite nice. It's sort of this gold, pale yellow kind of shade. That's Sunshine. I know it's not really picking up on camera that well. It's sort of gold, yellowish. So I'm gonna swatch Regal. It's this peachy shade. Oh, this feels nice. That's Regal. I know camera's not really picking this up. This one's gorgeous. This one's sort of like peach with a pink gold. It's sort of peach with a pink gold shift to it. I know it's not really showing up on camera at all, but I'm telling you, this is peach with sort of a gold pink shift to it. You know what, I'm gonna try and turn down the light a little bit so it picks up the shade a lot more. Okay, so straight away when I swatched it on my hand, the formula feels really nice and creamy, and it does have glitter, but it's like really fine glitter. The formula on this is a little different from, it's not the same formula as the Anastasia Umrizi highlighter. It's sort of more glittery, but it has sort of has fine glitter. I don't usually have a problem with glitter as long as it's not chunky. It's sort of like shimmery, I don't mind. Okay. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna try putting this on my face so we can get a better idea of how these actually perform. I think I'm gonna try going with Magic. It sort of looks greeny in the pan, but it's not really green. I'm gonna use this MAC 240S brush to highlight. Okay, so my first impression of this is it is quite glittery. I don't know if you can see this on camera. I'm gonna turn down the light like a little bit more so you guys can get a better idea. I'm actually gonna pick this up, but it is quite glittery. It's not just a little bit glittery, it's quite glittery. Spray a little bit of my Glam Glow Glow Setter. The impact. Whoa. Oh my god, it sort of looks wet now. Okay, I'm gonna try doing this with my Sigma High Cheekbone Highlighter Brush. So do you guys see this side? This is with the setting spray. It still looks a lot glittery. Okay. I'm gonna dim down the lights a little bit more so you guys can get a clear view. I think this is going to shine even where there is no light. I mean, it is quite impactful. I'm gonna show you guys a close-up of how shimmery this looks. Quite a bit. I just went overboard. I mean, that's what happens when you get a new highlighter. Hey, you know what I'm talking about, okay? So don't pretend like it's just me, yeah? Okay. As you can see, this is quite impactful. It's quite gorgeous. I mean, I do like it. This is going to be shining even in the darkness. So, this palette is exactly the same size as the Nicole Guerrero one. This palette, it's exactly the same. You get about 4.5 grams in each pan. The only thing is, this palette's retailing for $45. And this one was for $40. So $5 price hike is a lot. I ordered mine from Anastasia Beverly Hills directly. I paid $17.65 for shipping to UAE as well. I wish she did like free international shipping on $100 or more or something, because $17 for shipping is quite a lot. So I ended up paying about $62, which is like about 228 dirhams, like 230 dirhams. I believe this is not gonna be for everybody. Everybody's not gonna want to buy this, especially for maybe $45, which is quite a bit. But otherwise, it is a nice palette. I do like holographic highlighters. I mean, I do like colorful, unique highlighters. It is still very, very wearable. You still do have nice shades. Formula is nice, except it does have very, 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 very fine glitter in it. This is gonna be more for people who create those editorial looks or people who like unique and different looks. This is definitely gonna be something for them. I honestly like this palette. It is quite wearable. The theme in this palette is mainly pink lavender undertones. So if you don't like pink, if you don't like lavender, if you don't like fine glitter, you're not gonna like this palette. So all in all, it is a good palette. That's about it. So if you did enjoy watching this video, please do like and subscribe to my channel down below. Until then, see you. Bye bye.